Blackstone Audio presents The Twilight of the American Enlightenment, The 1950s and the Crisis of Liberal Belief by George M. Marsden. This book is read by William Hughes. To my former students, with thanks for all they have done. Introduction. Many Americans think of the 1950s as a time when American culture made sense. Some of us can remember why. We had won the war. We were enjoying unprecedented prosperity. And we were surrounded by visible signs of progress. Comfortable suburbs sprang up everywhere. I remember well how in the spring of 1949, when I was 10 years old, the fields near my home, where we used to roam, were suddenly marked off with patterns of stakes. A building project was launched with some fanfare. The developers even gave away aluminum horseshoe tokens with a 1949 penny in the center. By the next spring, our town had a full-fledged suburb where I would soon be delivering newspapers. In such places, more and more young families could participate in the American dream of owning their own homes, endowed with up-to-date modern conveniences. Everyone seemed to take the ideal of the conventional family for granted. The father went off to work, and the mother dedicated herself to raising the children. Typically, the front yards on my paper route were littered with bicycles and tricycles. For many people in the 1950s, an expanding amount of free time could be dedicated to entertainment. A small blue-gray TV flickered in most picture windows, leisure, and sports. Children and teenagers were among the chief beneficiaries of these changes, enjoying a whole youth culture of rock and roll music, films, TV shows, comic books, sports, and activities designed especially for them. Not everyone yet shared in the American dream, of course, but the nation was working on that. The society was becoming more and more inclusive, and the people within it were increasingly sharing similar values. Granted, a lot of problems remained to be solved. Yet there was little reason not to believe that if peace could be maintained, progress would continue. In many ways, the mid-20th century was a time of tremendous optimism. Americans were constantly being reminded that theirs was the best nation on earth. They heard every day that their happiness and contentment would only increase, particularly if they acquired the latest products. Probably no one quite believed all the hype, but still, in many ways, things, and it was especially things, were better than they had ever been. As Alan Ehrenhold, author of The Lost City, put it in that engaging look back at growing up in Chicago, it was not that the 1950s were a golden age, but that they were a time when life as it was seemed so much better than life might have been. Everyone could remember or had heard of enduring the hardships of the Depression, or could look back to or imagine coming of age in 1943, when boys were sent off to an incredibly grim world war. Ehrenhold recalls especially the forgotten virtues of community in America that still prevailed in the 1950s. Most folks' lives were shaped by the community of the neighborhood or town in which they lived. Well-known local people typically owned and ran the stores that were part of that community. Even when families moved to the suburbs, they worked hard at creating a sense of togetherness through community organizations and churches. One of the dimensions of the urban neighborhoods was the presence of authority, sometimes arbitrary authority. That was especially true for those who lived in Catholic neighborhoods, where parish priests often ruled with an iron hand. Every child who attended a Catholic school could recall nuns whose lives seemed dedicated to being God's agent for enforcing discipline, order, and uniformity. In all these communities, Catholic and otherwise, the authoritarian father, easily angered by the laxness and indifference of the younger generation, was a figure everyone knew of, either first or second hand. Yet, according to Ehrenhold, it is not just nostalgia to regard such occasionally strict authority as a fair price to pay for a sense of genuine community, a sense of community that has been lost for so many Americans of later eras that seem to be shaped by the chaos of choice.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.